Hello, everybody. Hooded Cobra Commander 788 here. Welcome back to Class of Fridays. This time we are looking at the G.I. Joe Classified Series Lady J. I've been looking forward to doing this one. I am intrigued by how Hasbro is handling female characters at this 6-inch scale. Let's start by looking at the packaging. The figure and accessories are clearly visible. We have the logo, G.I. Joe Classified Series Lady J. Then we have some artwork of the character. That artwork continues to the side and looks pretty good. The artwork for this Classified series is a little hit and miss, but my preference is for the more realistic painted style artwork like this. This is number 25 in the series, and the back of the box has that generic poster artwork that we're used to seeing with this series. On the other side of the box, we have these symbols which represent her specialties. This one means she's a big fan of the Punisher. This one means her three favorite directions are north, northwest, and northeast. This is a chain link fence, and this means she sometimes wears a hat and sometimes she does it. I am eager to look at this figure, so let's take it out of the package and check it out. Here is Lady J outside of the packaging. There's a lot to say about this figure, with points of interest with the accessories, the articulation, the sculpting choices. Let's get started. This Lady J classified figure is an update of the original Lady J figure from 1985. It is a remarkably faithful update, with a few nods to how the character appeared in the animated series, so fans of Lady J will probably be happy with this figure. Looking at her accessories, we can start with her primary weapon, which is this javelin gun. It can be removed from her hand, and this is a three-piece accessory. It's mostly black. It has this main piece here with the two grips, and then the javelin is actually removable. This is a callback to the vintage figure that had a very similar accessory. The javelin itself is two pieces. That spearhead can be removed, but it is a tight fit. There is this extra piece that looks like it's supposed to be an alternate javelin head. It can snap on just like the spearhead, and this may be some kind of explosive warhead or like a magic bubble machine like in the animated series. Who knows? My preference is for the spearhead, but it is a very tight fit. I'm worried about breaking it every time I take it off or put it back on. The javelins will fit in the figure's hands so she can throw them. That's more like how she used them in the animated series. Lady J had two javelins. The second javelin can be stored on the backpack on this clip, and we've got to take this backpack off and look at it. It is really interesting. The backpack is mostly green to match the figure's uniform. The original Lady J figure also had a green backpack in a lighter green shade to match that figure's uniform. Here's a cool thing about this backpack. You have two javelins and three javelin heads, which means one of the heads will not be attached to one of the shafts. So on the back side of the backpack, you have cavities for the extra javelin heads. There's a space for the alternate head. It fits right in there, very snugly, perfect. If it's one of the spearheads you need to store, there is a space for that as well. This backpack is not done with features. It also has a small camera on an articulated arm. It's all in black plastic, and this is highly articulated. You can get about every camera angle you can imagine with this. The original Lady J figure included a clunky 80s camcorder with a strap, and this backpack camera is a modern update of that. This is how you update vintage accessories to make sense in the modern world. The figure has some straps and belts that are separate pieces. They're not intended to be removed, but I'm sure you could remove them with some effort. On the belt, there is a sheath for a knife, a black knife that is removable. We've got to look at another accessory. The original Lady J figure had a hat. She did not appear with a hat on the animated Yes, this is a feature of the figure. It has a wig. It is in brown, soft, flexible plastic, and it can be removed. The final accessory is the hat. It's in a dark, kind of a navy blue with the G.I. Joe logo on it. There is some brown hair coming out the back. So this is kind of like a hat wig that can be placed on the figure. Just do your best to line it up well. And now she looks a bit more like that original 1985 figure. I'm really glad they did this. Lady J has two iconic looks. There's with the hat, as on the 85 figure, but in the animated series, she did not wear the hat, so you can have Lady J in both ways. Let's look at Lady J's articulation, and this is an upgrade from earlier classified figures of women characters. You still have the really good range of motion on the head, so all the way around, up and down, just everywhere. Up at the shoulder and all the way around at the shoulder, there is a twist at the upper arm and double jointed elbows, and this is is an upgrade. This is an improvement. Earlier classified female figures had single jointed elbows, whereas all the male figures had double jointed elbows. So now this is a great range of motion for the arm, and that's a big help. At the wrist, there is a swivel and a hinge. It's an up and down hinge on both wrists. That's really good, and you can get some good poses with those javelins. There's a cut at the torso for an ab crunch and a twist. There's a decent range of motion on that. That's a different method of articulation than on the male figures. The male figures have a big hinge that cuts at the rib cage. I don't like either of those methods of articulation. It really breaks up the uniform at that cut. There is a bit of a twist at the belt, but there's not a great range of motion there. There is a good leg split. The legs have to be popped back in their sockets, though. The leg moves forward at the hip pretty well, not so much back. It has a cut at the thigh for a twist. Double jointed knees, I'm a big fan of that. There is a cut at the boot for a twist. There are hinged and rocker ankles. Let's admire some of the details on this figure. We've looked at the hat quite a bit now. I'm gonna put on the other hair piece because it doesn't obscure the face quite as much. That hair is sculpted really nicely, and the face is not too bad. The eyes look a little wide. You have to be careful with eyes. It's very easy to make a figure look bug-eyed. This isn't too bad, but I have seen better. She is in an all-green uniform, just like the original figure, but it's in a darker shade, and I think that works better. There are some other spots of color just to add a bit more interest. There are some brown straps over her shoulder and on her back. They cross in the back with a bit of silver at the connections. There are also some straps around her upper arms, and I think these straps on her shoulders and back look good, but the straps around her upper arms just look a little odd. She has a gold parachutist badge on the right side of her chest. It is somewhat obscured by this brown strap. The original figure had that badge on her hat. She has a blue and white patch on her left sleeve. The original figure also had a patch. On both of my figures, unfortunately, it's kind of worn off, so you can't see it very well. This is a direct callback to the patch seen on Lady J in the animated series. Attention to small details like this in the classified series is one of the reasons why I enjoy it so much. There is the thin brown strap that cuts a diagonal across her chest and back, and on the back there is a hole in the strap that lines up with the hole on the action figure for the peg on the backpack. There is a brown painted belt with a silver belt buckle on the figure itself. Then there is this belt piece that has a couple straps. There is a pouch on the back. There is the sheath for the knife, and there is this blue circle communicator thing that we saw on earlier classified figures. I kind of thought they gave up on this, but here it is again. She has rolled up sleeves and bare forearms. She has black gloves. This is all perfect for Lady J. If there's any complaint I have, it's that she's very skinny, as are all of the G.I. Joe female figures in the classified series. With the male figures, we have several different body types. Some are average, some are a little taller, some are more muscular than others, but for G.I. Joe, there is only one female body type, and that is super skinny. On the torso and on the legs, there is texture and subtle color differences, and this is good. It would be very easy for a uniform figure like this to be monotonous, but this just adds a little bit more to it, so it's just not all monochrome, not all just one green color. Using all one color at the 3¾-inch scale is not too bad, but at the 6-inch scale, without something to break it up a bit, it would be too much. The legs are in the same basic green color as the top half of the figure, and I'm happy about that. They didn't go too crazy with the colors. This looks like Lady J. She has some pockets and some knee pads, and then she has these tall black boots. These boots look really nice. They're well detailed, and they have these shin guards. These shin guards look a lot like the ones that were on the early wave classified figures. On the first wave of classified figures, they had some common design elements like metallic shin guards and communicator devices. And with these shin guards and with the communicator on the belt, I kind of suspect that Lady J would have originally had a deco similar to those first wave classified figures, but at some point in pre-production they changed their minds, decided to make the shin guards black, but they still had that communicator on the belt. That was my review of Classified Series Lady J. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll be doing classified figures every Friday. Don't forget, I have vintage G.I. Joe toy reviews every weekend, and I have a huge back catalog of reviews, so check those out and subscribe for more. You can find me on social media on Facebook and Twitter, and I have a website, hcc788.com. Patreon is what helps helps me continue doing these videos. If you'd like to support the channel, that's a great way to do it. You could get your name in videos. Thank you very much for watching. I'll be back with more vintage and classified G.I. Joe toy reviews. Until then, remember, only G.I. Joe is G.I. Joe.